All right, so the session is getting recorded. Last time we had covered social media marketing, social media monitoring, and Facebook marketing. If you want to check the overall recording of the previous session, guys, I'm just going to give you the overall the link which you can access in order to look into the previous sessions, guys. So I'm just going to type that across into the chat window. All right, so just try clicking onto the link which I have shared across with you in the chat window, guys. So in case you are watching. All right, so last time we had covered a session on, let me go into the playlist section. So what you have to do, the link which I have provided you, you can go ahead and click onto that and you can look into this particular batch, which is the Monday batch. Actually, the Monday batch got shifted to the Saturday. All right, so there are a lot of videos over here which you can get to see. Last time it was all about the SEO tools, guys. SEO tools in terms of the web SEO, running Screaming Frog, and online reputation management. And we had covered that across. There was another video on social media marketing, which I believe have been uploaded, but not have been added to this playlist. I'll do that across. So you can watch all the videos, guys, which have been covered previously. Today, we're going to start with Facebook advertisements. All of you are, so we have Facebook advertisements, which we get to see on our day-to-day browsing across on Facebook. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to open my Facebook account. I'm just going to log in across to my Facebook account and then going to show you. So the topic which we're going to be covering today is how to go ahead and create Facebook advertisements effectively for a particular brand or a product. All right, so if this is my Facebook page, guys, this is my Facebook profile, you guys can open your Facebook profile as well. And on the right hand side, if you will scroll a lot deep down, you will see a lot of advertisement which comes onto the right hand side. You can see over here, there's a particular advertisement which is of the website called Udemy. I'm quite a fan of this particular website, and it is very much targeted across to me. And then we have another particular advertisement which is provided across by another website which is called InvisibleSellingMachine.com. All right, so since I am a sales and marketing professional, that's why these people are targeting me. Any idea how do we go ahead and create such kind of advertisements, guys? Anybody who has done that across, who has been part of creating such kind of advertisements? Anybody? You can let me know with a yes or no. I can definitely like participation to be there. All right, so Arushi says no. Anybody else who wants to go ahead and mention across with a yes or no, if in case you have any idea in terms of creating? All right, thanks, someone. Thanks, admin. All right, so we have someone by the name of admin. Can I get to know your exact name, please? That'll be great if you can let me know your exact name, or maybe you can go ahead and change your name in the guru meeting. All right, so guys, for creating such kind of advertisements, last time we had covered social media marketing and Facebook marketing, some of the things which as a social media marketing expert, we need to make sure while advertising across on Facebook. Those were the unpaid ways, the ways through which we do a lot of advertisement. Let me just help you with the recap, guys, of what we have covered last time. That will make everyone in sync of what we have covered last time and what we are covering this time. All right. So I've got all these presentations also uploaded across on SlideShare, guys. I can tell you how can you get access to all these presentations. All you just need to do is click on go to slideshare.net and type across digital marketing Pathshala. I'm just going to share across with you the URL. All right, so here's the URL, guys, for getting access to all the presentations which have been covered so far or would be covered across at a later stage. All right. So I'm just going to open across the presentation which we have covered last time, guys. All right. If in case you were part of the previous session, good. If in case not, I'm just going to rush across through the slides of what we have covered last time. So we started with understanding what all aspects are very much important in terms of marketing across over the Facebook. So it's all about creating a relevant cover photo, having 80% of the image, 80% of the area should be allocated to the image and 20% to the text. If you remember that. We spoke about a lot about how these cover pics should be created with the help of various other tools. So I had spoken about certain tools like Canva.com and also PageModo. If you remember that, PageModo, Canva.com are great tools, guys, through which we can create these cover pics. Then also I did tell you that we need to be consistent in terms of posting across onto our pages so that our brand image gets created effectively. We are always onto the top of the mind of our end customer. The end customers who have liked our page, they should get to know that what our brand is talking about. We should not just stay calm and be silent. So these are some good to know things. Then also choose a perfect time to post. I did tell you that you just cannot go ahead and post across your Facebook schedules, Facebook status across on at any given point of time. You have to be very much sure at what time you should go ahead and post so that you get maximum reach for your Facebook status. All right. Then also I told you to have high quality, catchy images. There are certain resolutions which needs to be taken care into. And also I did tell you that whenever you type across something, any status you type across on Facebook, it has to be short, crisp and clear. If you are going ahead with writing a lot of text across, then it's not going to add a lot, it's not going to make the end customer engaged. It's all about writing short, crisp and clear stuff so that they can go ahead and read that on the go. So most of the people access these social media sites on their mobile, and when they're accessing these social media websites on the mobile, they're on the go and they don't have the time and luxury to watch consume a lot of content. So you have to be crisp and clear. Also maintain relevancy. Whatever you're talking about, it has to be with respect to what your business is, what your overall industry is. All right. If you can have a video or a podcast is something like an audio clip, which you can create by yourself and then speak something and get that recorded and share it across on Facebook, whether a video or an audio, that'll give a human touch to the entire brand's Facebook page, right? That's again a good thing. Also have a call to action in all the Facebook posts, something like buy now in order to get 20% off, offer stocks last and so forth and so on. Buy today in order to get free shipping. All those things are something really good. All right. So Arushi says, is this the class immediate to class ORM? Absolutely it is. I'm not able to. All right. So you might have missed it, Arushi. This was covered last Saturday. Last Saturday, I mean. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to share across with you the overall recorded version, the URL of the recorded version. No problem. So this was something which was being covered last Saturday. All right, so use of relevant apps is something which is not, it's covered as of now because apps are discontinued. Then I also told you, does anybody recall that? Santosh, I believe you were part of the last session where we had covered this, right? That was last Saturday, if I'm not wrong. I did tell you how to be, you can be entertaining. You can post in funny pictures or videos in order to smoothen up the process. Thanks a lot, Santosh, for answering that. All right, so be entertaining, be educational. If you can post across a lot of content in terms of how to do this, how to perform certain kind of activity, how to perform such kind of stuff, something related to your industry where you're providing education to the end customer is good, all right, with respect to Facebook. So Arushi, even if you have missed, I am trying to encapsulate every single point in bit detail only. So despite of doing a fast recap, I'm really spending a lot of time on each and every slide. So I hope you can get what I'm talking about in terms of posting across content on our Facebook pages. All right. Another thing, when we are trying to do social media marketing with the help of Facebook pages, is to have a list of all the information which we want to circulate across. So we can have a lot of status update on various aspects, like what are the 5 ways to do these things, what are the good 10 tips for doing such and such stuff. For an example, let's say if I'm into the digital marketing industry, if I can post across a lot of content like 10 things which a good digital marketer do, 5 characteristics which an SEO professional, which a good SEO professional should have, such and certain kind of stuff, you know, which provides information in the status updates is something which is recommended. All right, so also you can have a lot of seasonal offers which you can create and then circulate it across. Let's say for digital marketing Pathshala, I start promoting across that in place of 7,500 fees for digital marketing Pathshala students, all those who subscribe to digital marketing Pathshala, they pay 7,500 fees. I say that from Diwali till or from Dashera till Diwali, it's going to be just 6,000 rupees, 1,500 rupees off. So I can go ahead and circulate that across. So I can have any sort of seasonal offers. So it was a Diwali offer or it's any festival offer which I can run across and circulate it across. It's definitely breaks the monotony. So we have to mix and match a lot of content. I know most of you would say that this is something which we see on an ongoing basis. What is new in that? Even despite of knowing such obvious kind of things, still a lot of marketers miss out on a lot of things. So these are some great ideas, guys, which we should use for promoting across content on Facebook pages. All right, having a great cover photo is something which I've already told you. The pixel size for cover photo is 815 to 315 pixel. One of the great tool, guys, which I had told last time and would tell it again, is canva.com, which you can go ahead and use in order to create great pictures for your Facebook pages. Canva.com, this is something which you can explore. Pretty easy tool to go ahead and explore. I'm not going to use it right now because it's not much of a rocket science. It doesn't involve a lot of technical aspects. If you'll try playing around with this particular tool on your own, you will feel that this is something which is very, very easy to actually go ahead and work with. All right. So canva.com, you can go ahead and create the kind of thing which you want, either a Facebook cover page, Facebook cover picture, or maybe a Facebook status picture, so forth and so on. All right. So going further, you can just go ahead and connect your Facebook page, guys. Your Facebook profile, you can connect across. You can go ahead and make changes to entire images which are being provided across over here for free. All right. So that's with Facebook cover photo and also the overall profile picture. The profile picture pixels are 180 by 180. Again, you can use the same tool in order to go ahead and create certain good, catchy profile picture as well. All right. So canva.com is a great tool, guys. I'll say that again. All right. So within the page layout also, the overall Facebook status updates which you're posting across, there are certain pictures dimensions which you should go ahead and use perfectly. Like you should have 504 by 504 picture pixel size. For mobile, it has to be 618 by 618, or also you can use 1200 by 1200 pixels also. So that's a recommended one. All right, there are certain more images sizes which you can simply go on to canva.com and search what kind of image are you trying to get across. All right, so this particular tool will help you with all the dimensions. You don't need to be a designer. You don't need to know how to work across on Photoshop or on CorelDRAW or any other designing tool. Only these tools are going to help you very effectively to go ahead and create some catchy images. All right, similarly over here, we need to have a good call to action. There is something called call to action which comes up over here. Let me show you how I've got a call to action for one of my page, which is Digital Marketing Paathshala. So a good call to action is a functionality which is being provided across by Google. So over here, I have the sign up button. This is something you can see new promote your call to action from your page. All right. So call to action, I can go ahead and change that across. I can edit this call to action. And I, in place of sign up, you can see I can have something else. I can have a call now button. I can have contact us. Let's say if I do call now, I can go ahead and enter across the number. Let's say, so this is something which has come up new. The call now, otherwise it was not there. So let's say if I go to HI India, I can go ahead and press across the number. All right, so I go ahead and click on the number thing, and whosoever will actually watch my page, Digital Marketing Paathshala's page, and simply go ahead and would click on the call now button, and a call will actually get made. A call would get made by clicking onto this number. All right, so you have the like us page, you have got plenty of other things over here. All right, so that's with the call to action. Then also you can get to see a lot of activities which is happening across on your page. So if I want to see, if I'm the admin of a particular page, I want to see what's happening with respect to my page, I can go to the notification bar, and within the notification, if I press it across, I can see a lot of activities which is happening. These and these many people have actually clicked one of my posts. So 46 other people, 25 other people, 44 other people at 8:40, which is today. Right now it's 8:50, guys. At 8:40, at 8:39, at 8:16, at 6:22, at 1:38 p.m. This is all for today, guys. These all notifications are for today, which is Saturday. Then for Friday also, you can see a lot of notifications which have come across over here. All right. I can also invite in people by clicking over here onto the invite page. I can also promote across to more number of people in the paid way. I'll just come onto the paid way, guys. We'll get started in the paid way once you are done with this small recap. So we can definitely go ahead and check for the activity. Also, there is another thing with respect to activity, which is to check what all messages have my particular page received. If I go into the messages tab, this only comes in only for the admin, guys. All those people who are owning a particular page, who's the owner of the page, can only get to see these tools at the top, insights, notifications, page, and so forth and so on. You can see a lot of people are asking me various questions. So whether it's regarding to the classes and a lot of other inquiries which are being sent across. All right. So that is with the messages tab. And that is what I wanted to show you. Now, then comes the insights part. Insights are something like analytics of a page. I go onto my page and I click on insights. When I click on insights, this gives me data from 18th of October to 24th of October. All right. And it gives me data in terms of how many people have actually liked. 34,004 people have actually total. These many people in totality have liked my page, which is Digital Marketing Paathshala page. It also tells me that 87,233 people were being reached across within this particular time frame, which is in the past 1 week from 18th till 24th. All right, my post have reached across to these many people. 194 likes were being actually accumulated within this 1 week, guys. All right, and when it comes down to engagement, 2,531 people have actually interacted with the page. Interacted in the sense either liked the page or comment the page, commented onto the page or shared across or clicked across onto the post. 1,571 people clicked on some of my posts. I have been running across advertisement, guys, because of which there are so many clicks. All right. How I have got, received certain number of engagement is with the help of paid ads, guys. I'll come onto the paid ads in a while. If I scroll further down in the insights, I can see some of the posts which have been created, submitted across on the timeline, have got a reach of 116 people, 130 people. Engagement is one. So there is only one person who has either liked, commented, or shared. For this one, there have been six people who 6 and 2, total 8 engagement which have happened. All right. So organic is 183 and paid is 0. When we say organic, in a non-paid fashion, nobody has promoted this post, but organically it has reached across 283 people. All right. So I can show you some more things. If I click onto the likes part, when I click on likes, it gives me information in terms of how many people have liked my page and they're from what all particular location. So all in all, for the past 1 week, these have been some of the unlikes. Unlikes are from some of the spammers, guys. You can ask me as many questions, guys, in the chat window if you have certain questions. Unlikes are these, and the likes, the net likes, the total paid likes and the unpaid likes. Paid likes are these, this color, and the organic likes which have come on its own are the sky blue, and this is bit of darkish blue, the paid likes. All right, so the dark blue and this are 17 likes, represent the 17 likes, and the organic likes are 18, and the unlikes are 9. In totality, the net likes are 26 after deducting and subtracting and adding all the paid and the unpaid and the unlikes. All right, so I can also get to see where are these likes coming from, guys. So from with respect to the geographic location, let me show you. So I can see these are the pieces. This is the reach, guys. And all right, so you can just play around with the entire stuff. You can export that across also. Insights, the way we get to see the geographic location is, okay, I have someone says, how the unlikes appear? Can we know from who unlike our page? That is very difficult. That is a great question. Who all have unliked? That is something we can't really tell. That is a functionality which Google hasn't given us. All right, so I can I get to know your name? Your name says Android attendee. So thank you so much for posting across that question. Let me just Kamal. All right, Kamal. Okay, got you. So Kamal, you can change your name into the GoToMeeting. I'm just trying to show you where exactly the geographic segmentation comes from. So they have changed their entire stuff. All right, so when I click on to people, right, okay. When I click on to the people part, guys, over here on the left-hand side, where we were checking likes, reach, visits, posts, and so forth. When I click on people, you can see there are a lot of spamming activities. Spammers have actually liked my page, which has 2,580. I never populated across my page to people based out of Istanbul, all right. So somehow there are spammers from Istanbul who have actually liked my page. Otherwise, from India, India is my targeted country where I'm just trying to promote across my brand. So 16,278 people have liked my page, and out of that, from city perspective, 5,393 from New Delhi, and from Delhi is 1,317. Gurgaon 589, Noida 477. There are some other cities which is from Istanbul and all that, which are not related. 2,104 from Ghaziabad. All right. So these are the insights, guys, which we can see as a marketer. All right. I can see much more insights, which is over here. Then moving further, it's the same stuff, how many likes and so forth. Then we can feature the content also on our page. I had shown that last time also. If I've got certain content posted across on my page, let's say I go onto my page and I have got a particular post which I want to feature it across on the top. Let's say I've got a post which is this one. Okay, this was posted across on 22nd of October. I can click onto the drop down over here and click on pin to top. When I do pin to top, what will happen? This particular post, guys, will remain onto the top of the page for next 7 days. Usually, what happens whenever we are posting across a post, whenever we are posting something, the older post goes down and the new post always come onto the top, right? So let's say something which was posted today will come onto the top, and something which was posted yesterday will go down, and something which was posted day before yesterday will come way too down, right? So the sequence will come in. But when we do pin to the top, what usually happens, we can do pin to the top of any particular post, and that post will remain onto the top for the next 7 days, no matter how many new posts are being posted across. So if there are 10 new posts in the next 7 days, all 210 new posts will come at the bottom of this post, which is being featured or pinned to the top. Pinned to the top and featured post, they both mean the same. All right, so we can feature a content, usually the promotional offers or all that stuff which we want to promote across aggressively. We go ahead and pin that to the top and we feature that across. All right, so we can feature that content. I've already told you that. And there are fabulous some more tools, guys, except for PageModu and Canva.com. So what is the benefit of pin to the top? Sandeep asked that. So Sandeep, pin to the top is usually used for certain promotional offers. If we are running across, let's say if I'm running that same thing, which I was telling you, let's say Diwali offer, the share offer, I would like that offer to remain onto the top. Whenever there is a new post which is posted across onto the page, that will usually make my older post go onto the bottom. I don't want my promotional offer related post to go onto the bottom just because of the fact that it is being posted, it becomes old. I don't want my promotional offer, my post with promotional offer, to go to the bottom because it has been posted a day earlier or a week or 5 days earlier. I would want that to be onto the top for next 7 days, right? That's the overall idea of for making a particular post come onto the top, which has got certain promotional stuff. Also, I think it's new to Facebook. It was there earlier, even 2 to 3 years back also. I remember very well. It was there earlier also. Maybe 2-3 years prior to that, it wasn't there. All right, so some more tools, guys, which I want to tell you. Woobox.com, you can play around with that. There are certain tools which are available into Woobox, which you can play across with. Canva.com, I've already told you. This is another great tool. Then you have PageModu.com, which is again used for creating pictures and cover pictures and status update and so forth and so on. Another great tool, guys, for creating across certain good images and offers and all that is shortstack.com. So I'll recommend that you go ahead and use these tools, right? Not much of a rocket science again. Once you use them, it's going to add value to your entire knowledge. And wherever you'll go, you can absolutely go ahead and let your clients, your interviewer, or maybe if you're doing it for your own business, you can make use of these tools effectively. All right, there were other five brainers, guys, which I had taken, which I had told last time. I am deliberately trying to spend more time on this particular, entire presentations, because some of you were not able to recall what we had done last time, which is not a problem, not a fault at all. These are the five brainers, guys. You should always have in your business card. You should just not have your name and your overall designation and your website and email. Along with all those things, you should also go ahead and type across the Facebook page if you can. That is something which is a good technique to promote across your Facebook page. A lot of people doesn't really want to go ahead and check out your website. A lot of people are very much comfortable checking out a lot of products and services on a Facebook page. So meeting the overall meeting such kind of clients or such kind of audience who are very much comfortable over the Facebook, you should promote across your Facebook page effectively, and you should have your Facebook pages URL or the overall Facebook page address mentioned across onto the business card which you get made. So have the Facebook page URL submitted across on your business card. Also have a Facebook vanity URL, which I did tell you last time also. You can create a vanity URL. A vanity URL is something like having a domain on Facebook page, guys. What I can show you how do you create a Facebook vanity URL is in this way. So you go to facebook.com/username, guys. Username. So all those who are doing it for the first time can get to know like this. You can type in facebook.com/username, and by typing this across, you can mention across to Facebook that what is the overall URL which you want to set for your personal profile and also for your business pages. There are two different things. One is your personal profile. So my personal profile would be by the name of Nick Bartla, and my business page would be by the name of Digital Marketing Paathshala. So I can create a particular URL, a specific URL for my Facebook profile, which can be facebook.com/nick.bartla, which I've actually done it for my particular profile. If I open, I have got a vanity URL across for my profile. So if I tell someone that I'm there present across on Facebook, I'd let them know that my profile URL is facebook.is something which is by default. I let them know that after typing facebook.com and after typing forward slash after that, just type my first name, which is Nick, and then dot, and then the last name, which is Bartla. That is the vanity URL which I've created for my personal profile. So I press across enter, and this is my profile, guys, which you get to see, right? So that is very easy in terms of letting people know the overall URL, guys, which is created across for your website. Similarly, I have created a vanity URL for my digital marketing page also, which you can see over here when I enter it across. It's facebook.com/google.adwords.certification. So when I tell somebody that if you open facebook.com/google.adwords.certification, enter it across, then the URL, the page which will open up is going to be author Digital Marketing Paathshala. I have deliberately made it across on Google AdWords certification instead of doing a digital.marketing.paathshala. There is a reason for that, because already for Digital Marketing Paathshala keyword, my website was ranking. I wanted my Facebook page to rank across for this particular keyword, which is Google AdWords certification. All right, so you can create a vanity URL. You can have your Facebook page mentioned across onto the business card. Number three, Facebook badge. This is something which has been discontinued, guys. So I'm not going to talk about that. This was earlier part of the Facebook settings. And also the last, the fourth point is to keep responding back to your overall queries which you get onto your pages. So there would be a lot of people who would be posting across a lot of queries, comments, and you know, a lot of posts would be posted, a lot of posts would be mentioned across onto your page. It's very much needed that you go ahead and reply back to that stuff. It is very much needed that you go ahead and reply back to all those comments and messages. So respond back to everybody, not a brainer, and also post a lot of content on regular basis. So that's what we have covered last time with respect to Facebook marketing in the non-paid version. Let's get started with the paid version, guys. The paid version, like I told you, any specific advertisement which you see onto the right-hand side, let's say this is the home page, this is the newsfeed page. What you can see over here, newsfeed. All of us know what is a newsfeed one, a newsfeed page, guys, which is the home page. When I click onto the home page, this newsfeed page actually comes in. And when I scroll further down, the advertisement which you can see over here, right? This advertisement and also this advertisement over here. If I click onto this, the advertisement leads me to a particular website. And the website which is going to open after clicking. So after clicking onto this ad or maybe this ad, the website which is going to open is actually trying to promote across its particular product. So somehow actually I have seen this particular product into the past. That's why they are promoting this to me. All right, that is called remarketing. We have covered remarketing in Google AdWords. If in case you have not been part of remarketing, we will absolutely take that in the other batch also. All right, now what we would do is we would take one of our website and we'll create advertisement like these, guys. I'm already running some of my advertisement for Digital Marketing Paathshala. Probably I'm not really sure if anyone has seen the advertisement for Digital Marketing Paathshala on Facebook. Has someone seen that? So all those who are based out of Delhi would might have seen it, because I'm not running my advertisement across on right. So Aman hasn't seen that. I believe Arushi might have seen that. Arushi, it was you who had seen my ad and then you called up, if I'm not wrong. Kamal also, I believe it was you as well who had seen the ad, right? All right, so Arushi had seen that, and I believe Kamal, you also saw my ad and then you contacted us, right? If I'm not wrong, I can't really recall that. All right. Okay. So on the right hand side, the way we create an advertisement, if all right, thanks, Kamal, for replying in. On the right hand side, where you see a drop down button, a drop down arrow, you need to click onto that and it will always give you an option. So this is your personal profile, guys. Let me tell you, first of all, in order to get started with the paid advertisements of Facebook, you have to have admin rights for the page of the business which you're trying to promote. So let's say if I'm trying to promote across digital marketing, Paathshala, I'm taking that one of the case studies. I would need to have, first of all, admin rights. This is one of the Facebook profile, one of the Facebook profile which I'm using across to make use of the Facebook paid ads. All right. You can use your personal profile too. When you log into your personal profile, you can go ahead and click onto the right, on the right hand side into that arrow. And when you scroll further down, you will see two options which says create AdWords or manage AdWords. All right. Just a second, guys. I'll have a sip of water. Excuse me. All right. So you get two options, which is create advertisements and manage advertisements. If I want to go ahead and create a particular advertisement for my brand, I can definitely go ahead and select the option of create AdWords. Or if I have already got certain advertisements running across, since I have got certain advertisements, I would click on to manage. I will just go ahead and click on to the manage AdWords first and show you how the overall advertisement platform of Facebook looks like. All right. So anybody who has got any question, any doubt, can simply go ahead and ping me across in the chat window and let me know their overall questions, guys. So you can see on daily basis, I've been spending across almost $40. So I've got dollars as one of my currency for running my ads. You can go ahead and select Indian rupees also. That's not a problem, since I've got international credit card. That's why I'm paying in dollars. All right, it's giving me overall small little things, small little information in terms of how many conversions, how many people have reached across. I can, so this is for last 14 days, guys. In last 14 days, I've got four major campaigns, guys. These are campaigns which I'm running across. One is for the Gurgaon, and there is another one for Ghaziabad, then another one for Indrapuram location, then another one for West Delhi location. All right. So what you can see over here, I've got, oh my goodness. So Gurgaon one is really not doing well. I can just go ahead and let you know why it is not doing well. How are you earning through these ads? Okay. It's just like Google AdWords a bit. Google AdWords is a bit different to the Facebook ads. Kamal, you'll when you will start running these, then you will definitely get to see how are they different. So with Google AdWords, you have the ability to create search ads with on the basis of keywords. Over here, you don't have keywords. These are not search ads. These are just display ads and just going to run across on the onto the Facebook platform. And how I'm so Anand has a question, how I'm earning through these ads. What I'm doing when I'm running these ads, people see my ad, they go ahead and click onto the ads. And when they click onto the ads, they land onto my landing page, which is on my website. Let me show you how the ad really looks like. So if I click onto the first campaign is some all about this. All right. So the underneath the campaign, there is an ad word. When I click onto the ad word, this is the advertisement, guys, which is running across right now. I would go ahead and click onto the advertisement. And then I'll just answer your question. So just keep listening to me what I'm saying. All right. So I go ahead and click on edit ad word. When I click on edit ad word, I had created this ad, which you can see over here, which looks something like this. People are able to see my advertisement on the right hand side, something like this, guys. Upscale and upgrade your career by learning dynamics of Google advertisements. Call such and such number And then there is this picture of Google certification and some more text. And when somebody clicks onto this ad, what they are actually getting redirected to is this particular URL. When somebody clicks onto my ad, Anil, everybody have a look. They go ahead and get redirected to this particular URL, which is the landing page. I have created this landing page on my website, which is dmpathshala.com. All right. It's loading up right now. Seems like there's a lot of traffic onto the website. That's why it's taking a bit time to actually get uploaded. What happens when somebody comes onto this landing page, Anil, they go ahead and check this entire content of this particular page onto this page. And after checking the onto the content, if they feel catchy enough, if they feel that this is something which is exciting, enticing them, they go ahead and enter their name, their email address, their phone number, and then they click on Get Course Details. We as at Digital Marketing Pathshala get the overall names and phone numbers and email addresses of all those people who have expressed interest in doing this course. They get to fill in this form, and once they fill in this form, we get their details, and then my particular team emails them or calls them across and asks them, you have submitted across your details. Would you be what details would you be are you trying to gather across? They provide them the detail, then they ask them to actually go ahead and attend a demo session. If they like it, then they go ahead and subscribe. That's how we are earning, Anil. So you guys pay us the fees, and how have we guys connected with you is with the help of the advertisement. Does that answer your question, Anil? So we are generating leads, and these leads gets generated into sales. Right, there is a process which is being followed across. Right, these are not AdSense ads through which we are earning. Right, these are not those ads which I'm letting others to run across on my website. AdSense is something different, Anil. So you don't really need to confuse between two ads. Over here, I am running these advertisements as a particular advertiser. All right. And if I want to earn out of advertisements as a publisher, then there is a different mechanism for that, Anil. I have my website over here. If you go and check my website, I have sold across certain space on my website on dmpathshala.com, and GoDaddy is actually showcasing its ad across on dmpathshala. If you'll open my website in your particular system, let's say if you I've given you the link. Try to open my website in your system. You won't get to see the GoDaddy ad. You might get to see some other ad. This will keep rotating, and I am earning by GoDaddy. So that is AdSense, absolutely. I mean, that is AdSense, which is running across on my ad. And this is you are advertising your website and yourself, but I mean to say, how can we earn through link? See, there are two ways, Anil. I'm advertising my website on Facebook, all right. And when I advertise my website on Facebook, I'm just trying to collect all the relevant leads database of all those people who would be interested in doing this course. Once these people go ahead and submit across their name, email address, and phone number, we get all these leads across. And once we get these leads, our entire sales team are telecallers, teleprofessionals, telesales guys. They call up and then they ask these leads, these people who have submitted their details. They ask them, are you interested in some sort of course to be done across in digital marketing? If they go ahead and say that yes, they are interested, we tell them to please go ahead and visit one of our centers or be part of our, what do you say, online sessions. And once they're part of our sessions, they like it, they attend it, they pay the fees, and that's what I mean. We get to earn from those people who have submitted across their details. You're not getting paid through Google for this. As an advertiser, I'm not getting paid through Google, but through Google AdSense, I'm getting paid if I am letting all the advertisers showcase. So GoDaddy in this case is actually showcasing its ad on my website with the help of Google Distribution Network. GoDaddy is part of Google Distribution Network, Google Display Network, sorry, not Google Distribution, Google Display Network. And they have come up over here with the help of Google AdWords. And I have sold this space on my website with the help of AdSense. I'm not really sure, Anil, if you have been part of my previous sessions where I've told in detail the difference between AdWords and AdSense. So if you have not been part of my sessions earlier, I would definitely recommend you to go through some of my videos where I have told in much more detail what is the difference between AdWords and AdSense and how do you actually earn out of both of them. Does that answer your question, guys? Let me know any doubts, any queries. Okay, so after completion of this course, how can I earn? So there are two ways. You can earn as a publisher, Anil, and you can earn as a advertiser. Is this your first session, Anil? I'm not really sure. So if this, if this is your first session, you can connect with me on WhatsApp. You can check some of our videos and get to know how you can really go ahead and run advertisements as an advertiser and how you can, the difference between AdWords and AdSense, and then you can earn out of both of them. All right, guys. So this is something which is an already made ad, which I've shown you. All right. I was going the other way from the back end way. Let me go ahead and start showing you the way we can create an ad right from the beginning. So what I do right now, I click onto the drop down button again. I click on to create AdWords. So I click on create AdWords, and then after clicking onto the AdWords, guys, there are a lot of options which are being provided across by Facebook in terms of promoting across my, in terms of doing a lot of advertisement. So number one is boost your post. I never recommend that. Boost your post is something like if I have a certain post on my page, let's say this is my page, which is Digital Marketing Pathshala. If I just want to go ahead and promote one of my Facebook post page only, then I can select the very first one. I can boost my post from here also, and I can boost my post from the advertisement panel also, right? Which is the ad manager. This is the ad manager, guys, which we have selected by clicking onto the drop down and clicking on to create AdWords. I never ever recommend boost your post setting, guys. From my experience, has been all about burning cash. Something which is very much recommended and I'm quite a fan of is increased conversions on your website. All the other ones are good, but it's all about branding, most of the other ones. Promoting your page is all about getting likes to your page. Again, it's all about burning money, not getting a lot of return. Send people to your website or increase conversions on your website are something really good. Then if you have a mobile app, let's say an app on operating system, an Apple operating system or Windows or BlackBerry or Android, you can go ahead and promote across your app also with the help of this particular option. You can enter across, after clicking onto this, you can enter across the URL of your app and then do the targeting. How targeting is done, I'll show you with the help of these particular sections also. Let's get started with this option, which I am very much a fan of, which is increased conversions on your website. Let's say when I go ahead and click onto this, the very first one, I am asked in terms of entering the URL which is to be promoted across. All right, so I have certain URLs, guys, which I've already created with the help of one of my landing page tool. I am going ahead and opening my landing page tool. Excuse me. All right. So creation of landing page, guys, I use instapage.com. You can also be part of that. I had a session in the past for all those people who have been part of this batch. The actual people, I would say, they have been made to actually see this particular tool. In case you have not been part of that session, you can definitely go ahead and check the recording of one of the session, which does talk about how to create a landing page with the help of instapage.com. All right, so I have got my credentials over here on Instapage. I go ahead and log in. This is a paid tool, guys, but some of its features are available for free also, which you can definitely go and explore. So mine is a paid tool. I've got certain pages being created across. What I'm doing right now, I've got certain pages already running across. So this is one of the Gurgaon related one, which for which I'm gonna go ahead and run across. Let me see if there were some leads which have come in. Okay, it's taking some time to open up. All right, this is the wrong page which I've opened up. All right, so just a second, guys. I have opened up the wrong page. All right, so this is the page which is to be used across. All right, so this is one of the landing page, guys, which I'm going to use across for promoting across on the Facebook with the help of the advertisement. This landing page will get appear into in the front of in front of the those people who would click onto my ads. I'm going to make my advertisement appear in front of those people whom I want to. I would do a lot of very specific targeting, very specific, very specific targeting in terms of who can see my ad, at what time they can see my ad, and what age group level, what interest, so forth and so on. All right. So I go ahead and click onto the Facebook advertisement panel. And I enter the URL, which was this, right? This is the same URL, guys, which I was showing you in a while, which is this one, right? The landing page URL is being copied and being submitted across onto this particular tab, all right? So once I do that, I go ahead and so there's something called conversions, guys, which I'm going to show you after a while what exactly it means. This is all about setting up certain code onto your landing page to make to get to know how many people have filled up form on your website. So I'll show you that after a while what exactly the pixel thing works. The very first thing is to enter the URL and then go ahead and click on set audience and budget. You click on set audience and budget. Overall things which you get to see over here is this. First is the location part. Let's say if I want to go ahead and make it as Gurgaon. All right, so I can go ahead and click on Gurgaon, guys. Gurgaon, the Haryana one. All right, so I go ahead and select that. And once I do that, my ad is going to be appearing across for the entire Gurgaon region. All right, so I can go ahead and so this is selecting a lot of area into the Faridabad location and regions across. I don't want to get that deep. I don't want to make my advertisement appear to a lot of people in the New Delhi or the Faridabad region. I can decrease the overall radius, the overall diameter from 20 kilometer to, let's say, no radius being there. All right. So it's only Gurgaon, which is I have selected. I can also do a custom one. Let's say if I do it, instead of 20 kilometers, I can go ahead and do 2 kilometers. All right, so this is the entire 2 kilometer. Okay, 17. How come 17.02? Strange. 2 kilometers. Again, it's doing 1.7. 5 kilometers. Strange. This is not taking 5 kilometers at all. It's again taking. So I think I cannot go less than 17 kilometers. So I would rather go ahead and click on no radius, guys. All right, so I'm not selecting any radius. This is something which I also got to know just now, that I cannot go lesser than 17 kilometers. So I have selected the location where my ad is going to be shown across. On the right hand side, guys, you can see there are more than 10 lakh people which are using Facebook within this region. More than 10 lakh. This is 10 lakhs, right? Yeah, absolutely. This is 10 lakh people. All right. So I can go further down and decrease this. I don't want to show my ad to everybody in Gurgaon who's using Facebook, right? Why should I show my ad? Not everybody is going to be fond of digital marketing. I have to make sure my ads get shown across to that set of people who would be interested in it, and all those who would be somehow interested would get to see my ad, and my conversion ratio will increase in that case. I don't want to show my ad to someone who's 65 years old and who would never ever even be bothered about it, right? That what exactly it is all about. As per my existing set of audience, I know that the audience which I get is between the age group of 18 to 30, or maybe 25 or 30, maybe that's it. 18 to 30 is the maximum audience which I get. I want to target both men and women both. So you can see from 10 lakhs, it got decreased to 7,10,000. I'm getting so much specific. The idea is to actually hit the bullseye. I don't want to show my ad to everybody. I want to show my ad to a certain set of audience, which is going to be somewhat interested into my particular product. Now the languages part, I can select a language. Whether I want to showcase my ad to those people who have written English as their form of language in their profile. So when I select English, you can see from 7,10,000, and this goes to 6,90,000. But I'm not going to use this across because not everybody enter their language. All right, not everybody enters. So I don't want to miss out on those people who have not written language into their profile. All right, I go further down, click on more demographics. I can segment people onto the basis of relationship. So since my product has got nothing to do with relationship, so I'm not going to use that. Had I been promoting across a different kind of product, let's say matrimonial site, if I have a matrimonial site which I'm promoting, I will always use this particular option very effectively. All right, reason being, I just want to target those people who are not married, who are just single, all right? Who are not married, I would be focusing across on those people onto the basis of relationship. I can select people onto the basis of education also. So do I want to target certain kind of people who have studied certain set of subjects? At present, I don't want to. I could have done that. I can also select on the basis of work. If I want to show across my ad to those set of people who are in certain specific organizations. So let's say if I click on employers, I can click on employers and select, let's say, Infosys. Right? I select on Infosys. I can select HCL. I select HCL Noida. You can see a lot of other organization, HCL Chennai, HCL Noida Sector 125. A lot of options are coming across. This is making my entire set of audience going further lesser. What is going to happen in this case, my particular ad will be shown to those people only who are working with Infosys. Who have written in their profile, they're working with Infosys Noida or with HCL Noida. I don't want to go ahead and do that. I can use plenty of other things like with respect to home, generation, ethnic affinity is something which is not used quite a lot. Parents also not, and politics is the US for US. Life event is also something which I can go ahead and select. And I can, so this is something which is used very effectively for different kind of products. Let's say somebody who has got an anniversary in next 30 days, and I am promoting across a particular product which couples usually buy and gift it across to their better halves. All right, so I can select and target those set of people who have got anniversary coming in next 30 days, or I can select for those people, make my ad show to those people who have got into a new relationship recently, or who have recently been engaged or recently moved, so forth and so on. So on the basis of life events, on the basis of employers, languages, so forth and so on. But my product has got nothing, no importance with related to that. Sometimes I make a lot of use of the education part, because sometimes I try to make my ad shown across to that set of people who are studying in certain schools and universities. let's say if I do on schools and universities, I can see what all schools are in Gurgaon. So I can do Amity University, Gurgaon. I can make my ads shown across to those people. I can make my ads show across to people who are in ILM Gurgaon. I can make my ads shown across to people who are in MDI Gurgaon. So see, this is becoming so much specific. Higher the overall targeting, guys, more specific targeting I do, my ad will become much more expensive, guys. So I can do select lot many other schools and colleges. If I know that my product is being used, or I would say my entire this training is being consumed by students only, then I can go ahead and select certain schools and colleges within Gurgaon region. So I can go ahead and check if there are more. Yeah, absolutely, there are some more. The other way, which what I can do is I can search over Google and find out names of lot of schools which are based in Gurgaon, and I can enter them. So let's say if I'm going ahead with these universities, only 40,000 people are going to see my ad, guys. Only 40,000 people who have got Amity University, Gurgaon, ILM Gurgaon, MDI Gurgaon mentioned across in their profiles. All those people on Facebook who have written into their profile that they are studying or they have studied in these colleges or particular schools, only they will be able to see my ad. Plus, also, if they are residing in Gurgaon, somebody who is residing in Delhi and have been going to MDI Gurgaon will not get to see my ad. Only those set of people who have been residing in Gurgaon, who are actually residing in Gurgaon, falling under the age group of 18 to 30, and also have studied from either of those universities or colleges. Only these people can go ahead and check out my entire, advertisement. All right. I can filter down my entire set of potential reach audience on the basis of interest also. I can mention that all those who are very much interested in web marketing, let's say. So if I click on web marketing, it comes further down. You can see my audience comes lesser than 1,000, right? I can have much more. Somebody who has written that they are interested in SEO, maybe, let's say, or search engine optimization. If I type in search engine optimization, only those people who have written that across into their profile will get to see my ad. See how specific it is coming across to, right? Search engine optimization. I can do where inbound marketing. I can mention online advertisement, online advertising again, pay per click, search engine marketing, online advertising again. So what you can see, 5,400 people are going to see my ad. These people have actually, there are 5,700 people at present who are falling under this entire stuff which I have mentioned across, right? So they have either mentioned something into their interest level, and all these 5,700 people have got such and such interest. Any of those interest have been part of any of those colleges, have been are actually within the age group of 18 to 30, and also residing in Gurgaon, right? Isn't this really cool, guys? I'm trying to promote across my advertisement and showcase my ad to the kind of audience which I want to. Display advertisement, landing page, content marketing, contextual advertisement. Let's see how much stronger my potential reach comes out to. Social media marketing, email marketing, web traffic, social media marketing. I scroll further down. So it goes to 6,800, right? See, I'm being so much specific. Google Analytics, search engine results page, affiliate, keyword research, backlink, link building, AdWords. So they all are coming across on its own, guys. Facebook is actually helping me with the same. All the related keywords, all the related interest are coming on its own, right? So I can go ahead and add some more and see how much stronger it gets. Much more targeted it becomes, much more price I would have to pay. if you remember when we started and we I had just selected the location was 10 lakh, right? So when it was 10 lakhs, and if I would have run across my advertisement to be shown across to all those 10 lakh people, maybe the per click cost in that scenario would have been way too lesser. When it comes down to 10 lakh, the mass audience, when you're not that much targeted, when you're not targeting across your advertisement to be shown across, then the price which you pay is way lesser, guys. All right. But in this case, when I'm being so much targeted that I have let Facebook know that my ad will be shown to such and such people, to so 27,000 people only, which is a very small group. 10 lakhs and 27,000, there is a huge gap, right? Only certain set of 27,000 people will see my ad. My per click cost in this case is going to be much higher, guys. It's going to be much more higher because I'm targeting only certain set of people, all right? I go further down, there are certain things like behavior, not much of a, I would say, effective thing, guys. You can go ahead and select people on the basis of the mobile device which they're using. So I can go ahead and select, I want to showcase my ad to those people who are using a certain set of a tablet or a smartphone or so forth and so on. I can select on the basis of digital activities, people who are using, you know, console gamers, Facebook payments, not much of, again, an effective thing, guys. Operating system being used also is mentioned across. So all those you're using operating system, Windows 10 will only get to see the ad. This is not much targeted when it comes down to Google, guys, to be very honest. Not many people use it. Underneath behaviors, you have category. Within category also, it does says that engaged gamers card game and simulation, not much of a great way to target across again. So behavior categories are not a great way. Then comes in the budget part. I can let Google know that I am going to spend daily a budget of, let's say, $5 onto this. All right. Or maybe let's say $10 onto this. And I want to run my advertisement continuously starting from today. I can set a start date and end date also. When I set a start and an end date, I can mention from 24th of October till 24th of November, I want to run it across. It's going to be $310 in totality. I want to run it across continuously. I don't want to go ahead. Now, I want to optimize my ad for conversions. All right. I want to optimize my ads for conversions. I do want maximum conversions, or do I want major clicks? Or do I want more impressions to be served across? What do I want? I have to select that. So let's say if I go for impressions, I want to charge, get charged on the basis of impressions which are going to be there. All right. So my ads will be shown across to people. On showing my ad to 1,000 people, I might have to pay in between 35 cents to $1.23. It's on my particular will. My particular wish, how much do I want to pay? But I have to pay anything between these two brackets, which is 35 cents to $1.23, guys. All right. So let's say if I, it's always recommended when you start for the first time, always go with bit of a larger bid. At present, I'm going to go with 1.20 USD, which is very near to the higher side. Always start with a higher bid. It's always recommended. This is from the basis of my experience, which I'm telling you, because Facebook works the best when you do start with a higher bid. As your particular advertisement will keep going stronger, then you can keep lowering your bid and move from 1.23 towards 0.35. All right. So I start with a higher bid, and then I can schedule my particular ad also. I want to run my ad all the time, or do I want a specific schedule also? I can do that also. This particular thing only works with lifetime budget, and lifetime budget is this. So I have a lifetime budget of $1,000. I can do it $100 also. If I have a lifetime budget, then the overall scheduling part will work. I can mention my ad. For what all, excuse me. So if I know my particular audience is active on Facebook on such and such hours, I can mention that across. Excuse me. Just a second, guys. Sorry about that. Thanks, Aman. Thanks for the blessings. All right. So I can mention across that I want to start my ad on Monday at 12 o'clock and want to do it till 3 p.m. Right? I want to run it across for all these time slots. I can go ahead and deselect that also. I can make my ad run it across from 12 p.m. till 9 p.m. so forth and so on. But I don't want to do it. I want to run it across for all the time, and that too, I don't want a lifetime budget. I want a daily budget. You can do a lot of permutation and combination. The reason why I do daily budget is because I want to keep track of things on day-to-day basis. I don't want to spend across $100 in one day, guys. All right. So I want daily budget to be there, and then I go ahead and click on standard delivery. This is the same thing, guys, which we had with Google AdWords also. I want my ads to be, equated across all throughout the day. I want my ad to be shown across on equally all throughout the day. I don't want it to get shown across during the early hours. Right, then I go ahead and click on AdWords set name. I can mention Gurgaon, and then this is actually about schools and colleges. And then I go ahead and click on choose AdWord creative. Now the next thing, guys, comes in after targeting. It asks me what particular image and what particular text do you want to go ahead and select, and also which particular page do you want to connect. Automatically this page, it gives me what's the best time for advertisement. That's a great question. That is very much dependent. I think it is Kamal, right? So Kamal, it is very much dependent upon the brand or the product for which you are promoting across. All right. So if I'm promoting across, let's say, women's handbag. All right. So let's say if I'm promoting across women's handbag, this has been seen that women are most of the time who are active shoppers, who are active online shoppers. They're on the internet during the afternoon hours and evening hours, all right? And if you're trying to promote your products, which is very much specific to, let's say, men, working men, then they generally go ahead and check internet during night hours after they work. So you have to really see what kind of product, what kind of audience. The product which you're selling across is catering to which audience, and that audience is active majorly at what hours. For my audience, it's a mixed audience, guys. It's a mixed audience. I have students and I have working professionals both. And students most of the times check their Facebook when they are in school and college and their colleges also. So I would like my advertisement to be shown across to those college students when they are during the daytime. And I would also like to show my advertisement to working professionals when they are checking Facebook during the late evening hours. All right. So does that answer your question? So it lot depends upon the product and service, Kamal, which you're trying to promote. And that product and service is being used by what kind of audience? So the overall usage of your audience is the answer. All right, so I can go ahead and select what particular page I want to go ahead and connect. I am admin of Digital Marketing Paathshala, so I'm selecting Digital Marketing Paathshala, no other page. Does that answer your question, Kamal? Let me know. I can go ahead and select an image. So I have certain images which I have already got into Facebook. I can go ahead and click on browse library. Why only two pages came here? All right. Great, Santosh. Good question. So what happened? This particular profile which I have, certification, I've got 2 to 3 pages which this particular profile is the admin of. This particular profile, which is by the name of certification, if you see over here, that is admin of Digital Marketing Paathshala, specialty certified medical assistant. And there was one more. Okay. I'm just part of, I'm admin of two pages only. So all those pages which you are admin of, only that pages will come in. So if you have a Facebook page of yours, you are the admin of that page, only that page will come. If I would have used a different profile of mine, my different personal profile is actually admin of 52 Facebook pages. In that case, 52 pages would have come. How many pages can we create from one profile? I think it's maximum 100, Aman. It's maximum 100, which I'm aware of. I'm not really sure whether Google have changed something onto that, but you can have 100 pages in totality. All right, so I select digital marketing Pathshala. I was on to the top. On the top, I can go ahead and select the image, guys, which I want to keep for my advertisement. You can go ahead and click on upload and select it from my from your machine, or you can, the other way is you can click on browse library. So I had actually set up certain advertisements in the past. All right, I had set up certain advertisements in the past. That's why I have uploaded some of the images within my Facebook advertisement advert managers. So that's why I'm clicking on browse library. If you will click on browse library, you will not get any image if you're doing it for the first time. For you, it would be upload. Since I've done it into the past, I have created a library in my Facebook AdWord profile. I will get a library of mine. You can see a lot of images in my library, which I've uploaded in the past, comes in over here. I can select any of those. See, all these were actually uploaded by me in the library in the past. I would go ahead and select the same image which I usually go ahead and select, which is this. And then I go ahead and click on done. All right, so when I click on done, this image gets selected, and I go further down. This is how my advertisement is going to look like. All right, guys, I can select the headlines. I can select and write the headlines on my own. So get Google, let's say I write in certified, and I write upscale, excuse me, upscale and upgrade your career by learning dynamics of Google advertising. Call 8 1 2 3 4 5 5 7 2 5 5. Okay, so there are two words which are going in extra, so I am actually exceeding the overall limit. So 90 characters is the limit, guys, with respect to the text, and with respect to heading, it's 25, I believe. Let me just tell you. Absolutely. So for over here on headline, it's 25 characters, and over here it's 90 characters. I can go ahead and delete some of the words. Upscale and upgrade your career by learning dynamics of Google advertising. Call such and such number. And once my advertisement looks like this, so my advertisement is going to look like this on the right hand side. I scroll further down. It gives me an option of what will appear over here. I can choose a button which can either say shop now, book now, learn more, sign up, download, watch more, apply now. I can select on learn more because this looks much more effective with respect to my advertisement. All right, I can select on show advanced options. Excuse me. I can write in. All right. Okay, Arushi says I am not feeling well, might have to leave early. No problem. So we are just done. Just 5 more minutes, Arushi. We are done with our today's session. So we would be done with the paid AdWords, paid ads in just another 5 more minutes. So newsfeed link, I can mention across anything which I go ahead and, let's say, post across. Learn the dynamics of Google advertising from the renowned experts in digital marketing. Call, so I mentioned across the number, let's say I can write in, there is a lot of content space, guys. We can go ahead and use that. So whatever content I posted, post comes up over here. All right, I can go ahead and then just click on the right hand side, when you see this is how my ad is going to look like, guys, onto the desktop. On the desktop, when somebody who's using a desktop, on the right hand side will get to see my ad something like this. And somebody who is using, actually, this is a newsfeed ad, guys. Newsfeed ad is the one which comes onto the home page. When I say home page, something like this. So let's say if I go into the home page, over here, the advertisement which will come is the newsfeed ad. There are certain times when advertisements comes over here, not the right hand side. This is a different ad, and there is a different ad which comes over here. This is called a newsfeed ad, and this one is called a right hand side ad. These are two right hand side ads, I repeat again, and the ad which comes over here is a newsfeed ad. And a newsfeed ad for somebody who is using a desktop will get to see the ad something like this. And a newsfeed ad for somebody who is using mobile is going to see an advertisement in the newsfeed something like this, right? Similarly, the right hand side ad, the right hand side ad for somebody who is using a desktop will get to see advertisement like this. And there is another thing called audience network, guys, which is on the certain websites which Facebook is part of. Facebook gets to show this advertisement on certain other websites. All right, they don't really go ahead and let us know. These are certain mobile apps. So Facebook has got connection with certain mobile, third party mobile apps, which you can see over here. It says adverts on the audience network are shown in third party mobile apps. But which all these third party mobile apps are, Facebook doesn't let us know about that. I can go ahead and place my order on any of those which I want. I can remove on any of those which I want. I can just go ahead and place the order, and that's it. We are done, guys. The advertisement is done across. I can go ahead and click on continue. Your order has been placed and my ad has got created. Similarly, guys, you can go ahead and click create an ad. You don't need what's URL tag. All right. So URL tag is something through which you can go ahead and categorize your URLs. It's just like creating certain buckets. I can create similar kind of advertisement with different URLs, Santosh. So with same settings, which is like same location, Gurgaon, same schools and colleges, same overall likes and interest, but I can run two advertisement with same settings, and both the advertisement will have different URLs, just to check which landing pages works best. There is something called A/B testing. A/B testing is like you have everything same, but only the URL will change. So I can mention in the URL tag landing page one, and in the other ad, I can mention in the URL tag as landing page two. I can create two different ads with everything being same, but only the landing page will change. Everything remains static, but only the landing page will remain different. Once both the ads will run, I'll get to see which ad is performing well. If the ad 2 is performing well, it means the landing page 2 is much more effective, because everything remains same. It's only the landing page is different. All right. So these are something more, guys, some more in-depth stuff. So this is under review. This will get this would be reviewed by Facebook in the next 24 hours. Google either will accept it or will decline it. I don't see any reason for this getting disapproved, guys. This will get approved, and this will actually get will keep going. It will run across for that particular set of audience which I have set it across. All right, guys. So that's what we had to cover today. Next session, we will start with Twitter and YouTube marketing. All right. So that's with the paid ads which I wanted to show you across today. I hope it was valuable and an effective session, guys. Let me know anything which you want to go ahead and let. Any doubts, any queries you have, let me know. Next Saturday, we would be covering Twitter, and we'll be covering YouTube advertising, all right, within social media marketing. So Twitter and YouTube is something which we're going to be covering. Any doubts, any questions, let me know. Aman, Kamal, Arushi, Moses. I have someone by the name of NK. I'm not really sure what exactly is your name. Sandeep and Santosh. All right. So I won't keep you awaited for going ahead and posting across the feedback. Okay, Nand Kumar. All right, great, Nand Kumar. Thank you so much for AdWords versus Facebook marketing, which is more effective. That's a great question. I would say AdWords is more effective. Edge ranking, sure, I'll take that in next session. So edge ranking is actually a formula, is actually a particular algorithm which is being used. So I'll definitely take that, Moses. I have to read something more about the edge ranking, and I'll educate something more about edge ranking and then let you know. All right. So anything else, guys? Thanks, Moses, for letting me know. Sandeep, anything else? Arushi, Kamal, Aman, or should we wrap up the session? Any other specific query, anything else, you can absolutely let me know on WhatsApp. Each one of you are connected with me on WhatsApp. Let me know. I'll help you out. All right. Thank you so much, everybody, for being part of the session today. Really appreciate for taking out time and learning much more stuff about digital marketing. I believe it was a valuable session for each one of you. If in case, thank you so much, Sandeep, for appreciating. Thanks a lot, Aman, for appreciating. I hope it was valuable for each one of you. If in case not, do let me know. I can surely go ahead and make changes the way you want me to do that. So not at all present, we'll let you know. Absolutely, absolutely, I'll upload the video. All right, thank you so much. Take care, enjoy your Sunday. Bye now. Enjoy, rest of your weekend. Take care, bye now, thanks.